Yo people, and welcome to a brand new painting video, also an introduction video about myself, because 4 years ago I also made an introduction video and it was a very lame introduction video, so I want to do it over. Especially I want to do it in English because I hope to get more viewers or more people who are interested in my kind of art. First of all, welcome to my channel. This channel is about art, painting or drawing. I do everything. Second of all, my name is Martijn Wickedpainter van 't Hof. I am a Dutch artist and also a Dutch YouTuber. I'm 33 years old. I live in the Netherlands. I am also a single father. I have been divorced 5 years ago and I have 3 children. One of the children is living with me and the other two are living with their mother. What I love about art. Art is something that always inspired me to make. When I was 5 years old, I started drawing because I have a difficult way to talk with people about my feelings. So I started drawing. And I never quit drawing. I love the drawing and I love to make everything that I can imagine or fantasize or dream about. And 15 years ago, I met someone and he teaching me the techniques and the type of way of painting. And when I started to paint, I fell in love with painting. I fell in love with the colors and the fantasy that you can also draw but also can paint. And that's why I start to paint also, and quickly painting takes over my life and past the drawing waves. I still draw, but most of the time I'm making sketches for my paintings. And also I love fantasy. I always dreams. I always look around me to make new types of drawings in my head. I sketch them out in my head and then finally I take a book and I start drawing. And I teach myself how to paint nature. I watch videos about nature. I watch other artists who makes natures and I start to paint nature. And some people love it, how I paint nature, and some people don't, but that is their own way, that is their own vision, how they see the art way. And quickly I start drawing and painting again, very very negative, because I get divorced and I'm by myself. And so quickly I fell down in a negative way, and that also infects me and my drawings and my paintings. So yeah. But you know, sometimes you fell down and hit your head against the wall, and I also did. So I hit my head and I start to think about what am I doing. I am must getting up for myself and also for my children, and I start to rise up a little bit and start to work on myself and also again on my drawings and paintings. And after a couple years that I was divorced, I have a positive way. I start to see things positive. I quit smoking, I quit drinking, and eventually my daughter is living now with me, and she is one of my biggest inspiration right now. When she starts to draw, I want to make a painting of it or draw over it and make my own kind of art, and I love it. I love the way children have their own imagination, their own fantasy. And I love when my daughter starts talking about dreams, what she dreams about, and quickly I start drawing in my head what she's dreaming about. And then eventually I take a paper and I start making little sketches, and with those sketches I make one painting. And I cannot explain why I love to draw or what I love about painting, because I don't know anything about real art. Like, I know a couple of names like Van Gogh and Rembrandt and Da Vinci, like those names, but I'm not inspired by those names. I'm not I don't know. I just love to draw, and I love to paint. And there is one man who really inspired me to make a different type of way of art, and that's Greg Carola Simpkins. He is an incredible artist. I love to watch his videos, and I also put in the description his channel and go watch his art, because what he makes is just unbelievable, and he is one of my inspiration brands inspirations to make my own way of art, my own way of type of paintings and also drawings. And I love his way. When I see his videos and what he makes, it's just unbelievable, and it inspires me more and more to devolve and evolve my type of ways of art and drawings. And what he makes is just incredible. So I start to watch a little bit around, and I think about myself, I want to paint my best buddy, and my best buddy is my cat. I'm not a big cat lover or something, but my cat Skull is his name. He has a skull texture on his face. That's what I see. He is my best buddy. He helps me to get through difficult times, and when he talks to me, like, he's an incredible animal. He's just so lovely and so fun, and I love him dearest by my heart. So I want to make him a little bit famous, and I start to draw him with a type of ball on his face, and those balls are also my own fantasy, and I use them in all types of ways, but I also put it on his face with a little key mirror like type of way, when you can see his eye, and I love it. It's just incredible, and I start to paint him more and more and more and more, and he is one of the many reasons that I make my own fantasy, my own art. Those peoples are helping me, also my cat, helping me to evolve in my paintings and evolve in my drawings. And now I start teaching children on my daughter's school how to use their imagination, and also how to use their own way of making art. And a couple of years ago, before the pandemic, I teaching them how to paint. So I go to school, and I have a little group of most of the time 11 people, 12 people, and I start to teach them painting and use their own imagination, and they love it. They love me for who I am, and they are not someone, they are not judging me about how I look, because I have a very strange appearance. Most of the people are a little bit scared of me. I don't know why, but I just wear what I love to wear, and I look how I want to look, and people are judging me by how I look, and that makes me sometimes a little bit insecure. And I don't know why they do it, because they don't know what I am wearing or why I am wearing that kind of stuff, but it's me, it's just who I am. And I'm on the inside, I'm different. I am an artist, and I want to express myself by making art, and that's why I love children how they are. They are not judging you by your appearance, how you look. They judging you by how you are from the inside, your character, your energy, your charisma, and all those types of way. And those children are starts to hang out around me, and they coming into the classes, and we're gonna have fun, and I also teach them to paint, and the group is getting bigger and bigger and bigger. But yeah, unfortunately my daughter was back to the mother, and now she lives a year. Yeah, I think now she lives a year with me, and I start teaching again, but in a different way because the pandemic. So yeah, I cannot go to the school and give them the normal lessons, so I have to do it by the computer. And still, they love it. They love the way I make my art or draw, and how I teach them in a type of way of fun. And from every teacher that I have a class lessons, they say the children loves you and they have plenty of fun with you, and how energetic you are, and how you show yourself. And that's why I also love the type of energy around children. And I want to make fun with them and draw with them and show them that their imagination is very important to us, but also the rest of the world, but especially for themselves. And they have to express themselves by drawing, sculpting, painting, anything around that kind of way. Because if they come home, they throw their box down or her bags down and starts to play games. And I find that very sad to see children always playing games. They have also a fantasy, a type of way, and they have to express those types of feelings, hurt, emotions, you know, like that kind of way. And I want to help them to get those emotions a kind of release, you know. So in a short way to say why I love art is the imaginations of a child, my own imaginations, dreams from a child, dreams from my own, and making people happy with my kind of art. Also, I love to make myself happy by expressing myself and tell my stories. But if you want to know more about me, we can also do a Q&A if you want to like that. So leave something in the comments, and maybe a question, and maybe one day I will do a Q&A and I will talk more about why I love art, or who I am and what I do in all my life, or what I'm not doing in my life, or what I hate, or something. Just ask me anything and I will answer it in type of way of art, especially. So yeah, I hope you all like this video. It's a new way to talk about me, and yeah, knowing me and telling about myself and how I live and what type of way, or why I love art and why I love making art. So yeah, I hope you all like this video. And if you're new, please subscribe, and if you don't, you don't. And I will all see you the next time. Oh, and please leave a like on this video. please. But yeah, that's what I have to say and tell about myself, and I will all see you in a next video that probably comes around a month or two, but I'm not for sure. Painting, you cannot over restorate it and make it quickly. Painting is something that takes time. So yeah, I will all see you in the next video. Bye.